إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله، تركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. أشهد أنه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين، فصلوات الله وسلامه عليه. All praise is due to Allah alone. We praise Him, thank Him, seek His guidance and His forgiveness. We repent to Him. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can mislead, and whoever Allah misleads, none can guide. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam in one occasion left his house and went to the mosque. And he found the companions sitting in the mosque in a circle. He asked them, "What are you doing?" They said, "O Rasulullah, we are doing dhikr. We are doing dhikr." So he said to them, I ask you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you are doing dhikr. They said, "By Allah, we are sitting here to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." Then he said to them that Jibreel alayhi salam came to me a little while ago and he told me that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is proud of you. Subhanallah. Once you sit down in a place, you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah the Almighty above His throne will be proud of you. And the least that you can get from sitting in a place to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that you will have your sins forgiven. You will have your sins forgiven. The ulama said the minor sins. And even though if your intention is not right, if you just came to see your friend, you didn't come to mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, still you will get the reward. In the sound hadith, Allah Ta'ala will ask the angels who go around and search for the circus of dhikr. He will ask them and say to them, "What are my servants doing?" They will say, "Allah Ta'ala, they are glorifying you, they are mentioning you, they are remembering you." And then at the end of the hadith, we say Allah Ta'ala will say to them, "And what do they want?" They will say, "They want your Jannah and your forgiveness." And he will say to them, "You are my witness that I have forgiven them." The angels will say, "Oh Allah Ta'ala, so and so amongst them is not from them. He came for a different purpose." Allah Ta'ala will say, "And for him I will forgive." They are the people, whoever mixes with them, whoever associated with them, will not be deprived from Allah's mercy. So the least they can get from such place and such assembly is that you will get your sins forgiven. So this is a glad tidings for all of us, inshaAllah ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this Quran and this book as a guidance, spirit, and direction to all of us. And in the Quran, Allah ta'ala told us that this Quran and this book, in every matter, in every confusion, in every issue, this book, the Quran, will guide us towards the straightest way. Not the straight way, but the straightest way, the most just and the most right way. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, "Inna hadha al-Quran yahdi lillati hiya aqwam." Indeed, this book guides towards that which is the straightest, the most just and the best way. In every issue you want, if you are confused about anything, just refer to this book and this book will guide towards the straightest way. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also in the Quran stated that He has revealed this book so that we may ponder on it, reflect upon it, and benefit from its reminders. So we have to ponder on the Quran and reflect on it. كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ. This book we have revealed to you is full of blessing, full of guidance. Why Allah Ta'ala you have revealed it? لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ. So people may ponder on His verses. وَلِيَذَّكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. Sahaba and men of understanding may reflect. And today, we will speak only about one verse of this book. Speak about the verse of majesty, the verse of loftiness, the most excellent verse in the Quran. The Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, in one occasion, asked one of his companions, asked Ubay ibn Ka'b, Ubay is one of the best reciters of the Quran. Said to him, "Oh Ubay, which verse in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most excellent? Which verse in the book of Allah ta'ala is the best verse?" Ubay said, "Allah wa Rasuluhu know best." Rasulullah asked him again, said to him, "Oh Ubay, I'm asking you, which verse is the best verse in the Quran?" Ubay said, "Allah la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum." The verse of the chair. Then Nabi Sallam placed his hand on his chest and said to him, "Congratulations on your knowledge," meaning that you have answered the correct answer. And then he said, "I swear by Allah that this verse has lips and tongue, and it glorifies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the force of the throne." And the hadith is Sahih Muslim, a sound hadith. This verse, it contains 10 sentences. And Allah's name is mentioned in this verse almost 17 times. Either mentioned clearly or it is implied within the verse. The verse begins with the greatest fact in this world. The greatest fact in this world, which is La ilaha illallah. Allah Ta'ala in this verse said, "Allah, La ilaha illahu." Allah, there is no God worthy of worship but Him. This is the greatest fact in this world. And because of the statement La ilaha illallah, Allah Ta'ala sent the messengers. Because of it, Allah Ta'ala revealed the books, the Quran, the Injil, and the Zabur, and the Torah, all the books, just to tell people that there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this verse, or this statement, because of Allah ta'ala, punishes and rewards. And it is the savior from the hellfire. La ilaha illallah. The greatest fact in this world. And then he said, Al-Hayyu Al-Qayyum. And ponder here. Al-Hayy is the ever-living. The one whom his life has no beginning and has no end. And time does not apply on his life. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Time and place do not apply on his life. Because Allah ta'ala is the one who created time and place. He is the ever-living, the giver of lives. The only absolute, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who gives life. Al-Qayyum. Al-Qayyum is the self-sustaining. The one who sustains himself and sustains all the creation. Everyone in this world depends on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, while Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in need of none. يا أيها الناس وأنتم الفقراء إلى الله. O people, you are the poor in your relationship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والله هو الغني الحميد. Allah ta'ala is the all rich and the only absolute. إن يشاء يذهبكم ويأتي بخلق جديد. If he intends, he can just wipe you out. He can exterminate you. By one order. Be and it is. وَيَأْتِي بِخَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ. And he can bring another nation. وَمَا ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ بِعَزِيزٍ. And this is a very simple matter to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الْحَيُّ الْقَيُّومِ. And then he said, the third sentence, he said, لَا تَأْخُذُهُ سِنَةٌ وَلَا نَوْمٌ. A sign of his complete life, a complete kingship, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that slumber, which is drowsiness, slumber or sleep, do not overtake him. Slumber, sleep, and unawareness do not apply on him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This creator, subhanahu wa ta'ala, requires no rest, requires no sleep. In the sound hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't sleep. And the hadith is Sahih Muslim. He said, Allah, inna Allah la yanam wa la yanbaghi lahu an yanam. Allah ta'ala doesn't sleep, and it doesn't befit His Majesty to sleep. He lowers the scale and He rises it. And then He said, His veil is light. His cover is light. If He removes it, the countenance of His face will burn everything that His sight reaches. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. If He just removes the veil, the rays that come from His face will burn all of His creation. Will burn everything that His sight reaches to, and His sight reaches to everything. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And despite this, that He's, subhanAllah ta'ala, He can just by removing His veil, He can wipe us out, all of us. He is, subhanAllah ta'ala, is the most clement, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the oft forgiven. Although many of His of the people and the mankind, the jinnkind, are disobeying Him, are rejecting Him, are denying Him, and He's still, subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgiving them, and He's clement towards them. وَرَبُّكَ الْغَفُورُ ذُو الرَّحْمَةِ. And your Lord is the oft forgiven, the owner of mercy. لَوْ يُؤَاخِذُهُمْ بِمَا كَسَبُوا. If He punishes them for their actions, لَعَجَّلَ لَهُمُ الْعَذَابِ. He would have hastened the punishment on them. بَلْ لَهُمْ مَوْعِدٌ لَنْ يَجِدُوا مِنْ دُونِهِ مَوْئِلًا. But they have a day in which they're going to be accounted and they won't be able to escape from it. Subhanallah. لَا تَأْخُذُهُ سِنَةٌ وَلَا نَوْمٌ. Then he said, لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. And ponder here, subhanallah, everything in this universe belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything in the heaven and everything on earth, whether it's small or large, high or low, seen or unseen, belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even you are part of Allah's kingship. Allah ta'ala owns you and owns your property and your wealth. You are part of Allah's kingdom. We are part of Allah's kingship. And that's why we're going to stand before Allah Ta'ala in the hereafter alone, as slaves. إِن كُلُّ مَن فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Everyone in the heaven and the earth. إِلَّا آتِ الرَّحْمَانِ عَبْدًا. Except he will come and meet Allah Ta'ala as a slave. لَقَدْ أَحْصَاهُمْ وَعَدَّهُمْ عَدَّا. Allah Ta'ala has counted them with full counting. And He knows every one of us. وَكُلُّهُمْ آتِيهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَرْدًا. And that all of us, every one of us, will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hereafter alone. Without a defender, without a protector, without a helper, without an interpreter. You will be alone, standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you will look at your right, you will see nothing but the hellfire. Or in the other narration, you will see nothing but your actions. And you will look at your right and left, you see nothing but your actions. And you look behind, you see the hellfire. And then Allah Ta'ala will ask you about your actions, about what you've done in this world. You won't escape from this day and this meeting. And that's why one of the ulama, Imam al-Razi rahimahullah, said that the wise person is the one who prepares three things before other three things approach him. The wise one is the one who leaves this life before this life leaves him. meaning the one who doesn't attach his heart towards this life. His heart is all attached with the hereafter. Although he's living here, he's doing his best to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to be nice towards people and do the right that people have towards him. But his heart is attached to the hereafter. The second quality, he said, is the one who, the wise one, is the one who prepares his grave before he goes into it. He will go to the grave. He can't say, when I die, I want to go somewhere else. You go to the grave. If you are a wise person, prepare your grave. And the wise one is the one who pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before he meets him. You will meet Allah ta'ala, you will definitely meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then prepare for this meeting. So Allah ta'ala in the Quran said, لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. To Allah belongs everything in the heaven and the, and on earth. And in more than 20 occasions, Allah ta'ala in the Quran stated that He owns this universe. And He has the perfect and the complete kingship of this universe. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَمْ يَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Can they understand and comprehend that Allah ta'ala has the kingship of this universe, the heaven and the earth? When Fir'aun thought that he has a kingship beside Allah's kingship, and said that to his people, he proclaimed before his people saying, وَنَادَى فِرْعَوْنُ فِي قَوْمِ. And Fir'aun proclaimed before his people saying, أَلَيْسَ لِي مُلْكُ مِصْرِ. Isn't it the kingship of Egypt mine? I own Egypt. I own this land. I'm the king here. أليس لي ملك مصر وهذه الأنهار تجري من تحتي أفلا تبصرون. And these rivers are flowing beneath me. The water is flowing beneath me. Can't you see? Can't you discern? Can't you distinguish? I own everything here. When he said that, Allah Ta'ala caused the rivers to flow above him and he drowned them in the sea. And his wealth, his soldiers, his people, and his kingship, which he claimed, were not of any benefit to him. فَانْتَقَمْنَا مِنْهُمْ. And we took retaliation from him and his people. فَأَغْرَقْنَاهُمْ فِي الْيَمْ. And we drowned them in the sea. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا. This is because they belied our verses, our revelation. وَكَانُوا عَنْهَا غَافِلِينَ. And they were heedless about them. Subhanallah. If you, subhanahu wa ta'ala, just look at the sky. Look at the sky. This sky, if you were to look at it for years and years, you can't comprehend it. You can't measure it. Yes? This sky and this heaven is full of Allah's soldiers. Full of Allah's host. Allah in the Quran said, وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ. No one knows the number of Allah's host but Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the sound hadith, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the heaven has grown and it has the right to grow. There is no space in the heaven equivalent to four fingers, but there is an angel on it, either standing in prayer or prostrating before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's full of Allah's soldiers and Allah's host and the angels. And everything in this universe, everything apart from the fool of the mankind and the jinn kind. Everything in this universe glorifies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, surrenders to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and submits to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Apart from the heedless ones, from the people and the jinn kind. Allah in the Quran said, تُسَبِّحُ لَهُ السَّمَاوَاتُ السَّبْعُ. The seven heavens are glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والأرض ومن فيهن and the earth and everything in them. Everything on the heaven and everything on earth glorifies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ and there is nothing but glorifies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything glorifies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وَلَكِن لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ
but you cannot understand their praise and their glorification. Subhanallah. So Allah Ta'ala owns everything in this world and owns everything in this universe. And we are part of Allah's kingship. And we are part of Allah's kingdom. And we are all under His authority, under His power, under His dominion, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have nothing. We have no option but to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And worship Him as He commands subhanahu wa ta'ala.
لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ
Then he said,
مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ
Who is he who can intercede before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without his permission? Who is he who can challenge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Who is he who can contend with this creator subhanahu wa ta'ala and this benefactor subhanahu wa ta'ala? No one. A sign of his complete kingship, a sign of his complete kingdom, that no one can intercede before him, and no one can do anything, no one can achieve anything without his permission, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even the angels, even the angels. Even the prophets, even the prophets.
وَكَمْ مِنْ مَلَكٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ
يَرْحَمُكَ اللَّهِ And how many angels in the heaven and on earth?
لا تغني شفاعتهم شيئا
Their intercession is not of any benefit. Until
حتى يأذن الله لمن يشاء ويرضى
Until Allah Ta'ala permits and allow their decision. Even Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم يبهير after يوم القيامة will prostrate before Allah Ta'ala and then will invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then Allah Ta'ala said to him, O Muhammad, Now you are allowed, raise your head, and you can intercede now. So no one can just come and intercede to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and say, Oh Allah, let so-and-so to come out from the hellfire, or let so-and-so to be forgiven. Nobody. It's a sign of his complete kingship, subhanahu wa ta'ala.
له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه
Then he said
يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم
سبحانه وتعالى Allah Ta'ala knows everything before us and everything behind us He knows our history He knows our present He knows our future and we are all within the capsule of Allah's knowledge He knows everything about us. And we cannot be hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah in the Quran said,
أَلَمْ يَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ سِرَّهُمْ وَنَجْوَاهُمْ
Can they understand that Allah knows their secret? Allah knows their secret and knows their public.
وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَّامُ الْغُيُوبِ
And Allah knows all hidden things. Even what you say to yourself now, what you hide to yourself, what you hide inside your chest, Allah Ta'ala is aware of it. What you talk to yourself now, Allah Ta'ala is aware of it and He knows subhanahu wa ta'ala.
قُلْ إِن تُخْفُوا مَا فِي صُدُورِكُمْ
Whether you hide and conceal that which is inside your chest or reveal it,
أَوْ تُبْدُوهُ يَعْلَمُهُ اللَّهُ
Allah Ta'ala knows it. If you hold it, if you conceal it, if you hide it, or reveal it, Allah Ta'ala knows it.
وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ
And He knows everything in the heaven and the earth. So where can you hide from Allah? Where can we go from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Where can we run from Allah ta'ala? We run from Allah ta'ala to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We return back to Him. يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم. جبريل عليه السلام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, O Jibreel, why don't you come to us more frequently? O Jibreel, why don't you come to us more frequently? O Jibreel, you can't just come to us in few occasions. Come to us more frequently. Jibreel عليه السلام replied, as Allah Ta'ala in the Quran mentioned, وَمَا نَتَنَزَّلُ إِلَّا بِأَمْرِ رَبِّكَ. O Muhammad, we cannot move, we cannot do anything, we cannot achieve anything, we cannot descend from the heaven, we cannot do anything unless if Allah Ta'ala allowed, unless if Allah Ta'ala permitted. وَمَا نَتَنَزَّلُ إِلَّا بِأَمْرِ رَبِّكَ لَهُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِينَا. He has everything that which is before us, وَمَا خَلْفَنَا, and everything behind us, وَمَا بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ, and everything which is in between of those two, meaning ourselves, the angels. Allah Ta'ala owns us. لَهُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِينَا وَمَا خَلْفَنَا وَمَا بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ وَمَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ نَسِيًّا. O Muhammad, your Lord was never forgetful. O Muhammad, your Lord was never forgetful. He's aware of everything and he knows everything. يَعْلَمُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ. لَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ means that people cannot, comprehend or encompass any of Allah's knowledge unless if Allah Ta'ala allowed. People who are living in this world are only discovering Allah's knowledge. Although they call themselves scholars, knowledgeable people, they are here just discovering what Allah Ta'ala has allowed, what Allah Ta'ala has permitted for them to know. And what we know in this world as human beings is very little beside Allah's knowledge. وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Whatever you have been given of knowledge is little. It's so little. And subhanAllah, you see, some people are boasting of the knowledge. People are thinking that they are scholars, they know everything, and they challenge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they talk about Allah ta'ala what they don't know about. All the knowledge that we have in this world is very little and it is under Allah's permission. People used to, I think 200 years ago, no one knows about gravity. Yeah? Yes? No one knows about it. And now we have a lot of knowledge that is based upon gravity. But subhanAllah ta'ala, 200 years ago and 1,000 years ago, we were benefiting from gravity. We're benefiting from it. We're using it. Although we were not aware of it, about it. We were not aware of it. It is the knowledge that Allah has placed in this world. But we are just discovering it. And that's why, if you study PhD or study any master in research, the most common word that you will use always is maybe. Perhaps. There's no sure knowledge in this subhanAllah ta'ala, in this research. Why? They say, now they come with a theory and tomorrow they come with another theory that disproves the theory, the first theory. Because their knowledge is not a sure knowledge. But whatever Allah Ta'ala comes with is a sure knowledge. Look at the Qur'an. Allah Ta'ala in the Qur'an said, أَلِفْ لَام مِيم ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. This is the book which has no doubt upon. Everything in this book is right. Look at any book of any author. In the first page you will say, whatever mistake you see in my book, whatever wrong you see in my book, then forgive me, whatever. Isn't it? Yeah? But look at Allah Ta'ala in his book. This is the book has no doubt on. Full of guidance and full of blessing. And Allah Ta'ala challenged us to bring a verse like the Quran. And no one can bring it. And he told us in the Quran, قل ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا. If it was from anybody but Allah Ta'ala, they would have found a lot of what you call it, ikhtilafan, differences, yeah, inside it, and contradiction inside it. Subhanallah. So Subhanallah Ta'ala, whatever knowledge you have in this world is by Allah's permission first, and then it is very little. It is very little.
ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء. Then he said, وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض.
His chair extended, reaching the, over the heaven and the earth. If you want to compare between his chair, Subhanahu wa Taala, and the whole universe, the whole universe, the moons, the stars, the suns, the heavens and the earth, all of them, the planets, all of them, if you want to compare between them and the chair of Allah Ta'ala, is like a ring thrown in a wide open land. That ring is the whole universe. And that wide open land is the chair of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And the hadith is sound hadith. And if you want to compare between the chair of Allah Ta'ala and the throne of Allah Ta'ala, is like a ring thrown in a wide open land. That ring is the chair of Allah, and the throne is the wide open land or that desert. And Allah Ta'ala is greater than this. And we say it in every prayer. Allahu Akbar, Allah Ta'ala is the greatest. Subhanahu wa Ta'ala.
وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ.
And imagine that you are in that small ring. You are living there. And you are disobeying Allah Ta'ala. And you are heedless of Allah. You are neglecting His orders and His commandments, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. You are harming nobody but yourself. You are harming no one but yourself. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, إِن تَكْفُرُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنْكُمْ. If you disbelieve, Allah Ta'ala is not in need of you. He doesn't need you. وَإِن تَشْكُرُوا يَرْضَهُ لَكُمْ. But if you are appreciative, then Allah Ta'ala likes this for you. And he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran told us as well,
مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ مِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ.
What would benefit Allah Ta'ala to punish you if you were appreciative and thankful?
Sorry for the Spanish.
So what would benefit Allah Ta'ala if you are appreciative and thankful, but He punishes you? Allah Ta'ala won't punish you.
مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكِرًا عَلِيمًا.
Allah Ta'ala doesn't want to punish you, because He's the most forgiving, the most merciful. In fact, Allah Ta'ala, whenever you repent to Him, you return back to Him, Allah Ta'ala will love you more. You fall in a sin, you repent back, you turn back to Him, you repent to Him, Allah Ta'ala will love you. Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. You seek His forgiveness, Allah Ta'ala will grant His forgiveness, and He will give you more, He will give you His love. In the Quran, who knows about the verse that Allah loves those who repent to Him? Question to you now, inshaAllah Ta'ala. Allah in the Quran mentioned that He loves those who repent to Him. Who knows the verse? It is close to this. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التوابين ويحب المتطهرين. Indeed, Allah loves those who constantly repent to Him, and those who constantly purify themselves. So Allah Ta'ala loves those who return back to Him. In the sound hadith, the Nabi said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah Ta'ala is happier with the repentance of His slave than one of you would be if he came across his camel after he had lost it in a wide open land. Imagine you are in a desert, in a wide open land, and you have nothing but your camel, and on that camel you have all of your food, drink, means of life, map, everything is there, and you are alone. You slept under a tree, and then you woke up, you found that camel gone. And then he searched for it, he couldn't find it. After a while, he said, okay, let me just go back to that tree and sleep under that tree, waiting for death. He slept for a while, he woke up, he found that camel in front of you. So how happy are you going to be? How pleased you will be? Allah Ta'ala is happier with your repentance than that man who came across his camel after he had lost it in a wide open land. Because Allah Ta'ala doesn't want to punish us. And the deprived one is the one who doesn't repent to Allah Ta'ala. Allah in the Quran said, don't say, well, I have a lot of sins, I have a lot of evil actions, Allah Ta'ala will not forgive me. No. Allah Ta'ala offered the tawbah, the repentance, to those who killed the believers, tortured the believers, and threw them the fire. إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات those who tortured the believers and killed the believers ثم لم يتوبوا and then never repent to Allah سبحانه وتعالى فلهم عذاب جهنم they will have the doom of the fire ولهم عذاب الحريق and they will have the punishment of the blazing fire. So Allah Ta'ala is offering the tawbah for them. Don't say I have a lot of sins, I have major sins, I have evil actions. Allah Ta'ala forgives all sins. Allah forgives all sins, every sins, any sins. Just repent to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Barakallah. Illa al-shirk. Barakallah. Naam. So Allah forgives every sin but the shirk. Barakallah. Barakallah. Allah in the Quran said, قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم O my slaves who have transgressed against themselves لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله Don't despair from Allah's mercy إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا Indeed Allah forgives all sins إنه هو الغفور الرحيم And Allah Ta'ala is the all forgiving the most merciful. Now the brother mentioned something which is Allah Ta'ala doesn't forgive the shirk. Okay? But if someone committed a shirk in this world and then repented to Allah Ta'ala, will Allah Ta'ala forgive him or not? Will forgive him. So the verse speaking about in Allah la yaghfiru yushraka bih speak about the hereafter. In the hereafter, if you didn't repent from some sins, okay, Allah Ta'ala may forgive for you as well. But if you did not repent from associating in Allah's worship, Allah Ta'ala will not forgive you on this. Does that make sense? Okay? So in the hereafter, Allah Ta'ala may forgive your sins, but if you have any shirk there, no way. Okay, but in this world, even if you have a shirk and you repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Ta'ala will forgive you. Because the companions were not Muslims, they were committing shirk at the beginning. And then subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Ta'ala guided them and they became Muslims, alhamdulillah ta'ala. Okay? So Allah Ta'ala forgives everything but repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let's go back to the verse and finish the verse inshaAllah ta'ala. وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ وَلَا يَؤُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا And preserving the heaven and the earth or holding the heaven and the earth requires no effort from Allah. Allah in the Quran said to us, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُمْسِكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ أَن تَزُولَ That Allah Ta'ala hold the heaven and the earth not to deviate. Are you with me? Allah is holding the heaven and the earth not to deviate. وَلَئِنْ زَالَتَا إِنْ أَمْسَكَهُمَا مِنْ أَحَدٍ مِّنْ بَعْدٍ And if he leaves them, who can hold them? If he leaves them, they're going to collapse on one another. They will collapse on us. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُمْسِكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَأَرْضَ زُولًا And Allah Ta'ala is preserving the heaven and the earth, and this requires no effort from Allah.
وهو العلي العظيم. And he is the most high,
subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the most great.
And this was just a journey with one verse of the Quran.
Subhanallah, you see a lot of benefit in this verse. Only one verse in the Quran.
Allah Ta'ala has revealed this book so that we may ponder on it.
Okay, Allah Ta'ala, the Quran said to us,
يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاكُمْ بُرْهَانٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ.
O people, a clear guidance has come to you from Allah Ta'ala, from your Lord.
وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ نُورًا مُبِينًا.
And a clear light has come to you. That means guidance that will show you the straight path. So stick to it and benefit from it, inshallah ta'ala, and make it a source of guidance and a source of direction for you in your life. May Allah grant us all the fearness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and may Allah grant us piety, and may Allah make us from those who ponder and reflect on the Quran and benefit from it. Say Ameen. May Allah reward you for listening. Jazakum Allah khair. Wallahu a'lam. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Always the first question is difficult. تفضل يا شيخ.
بسم الله. Proverb. You say it's in the Quran. This law that any sin that a man requires, Allah will forgive him. However, those who killed and did not go into Islam will repent.
Those who killed?
Who killed?
Yeah.
People.
Yeah. And then?
Say, oh Allah forgive me. But they are not prayer people.
The last thing that you mentioned, is it? After they kill people and then?
They ask Allah for forgiveness,
yeah, okay.
But they don't come to a masjid or they don't go somewhere for prayers.
Good. Well, anything that you do, even killing people, okay, and then you repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah ta'ala will forgive you, okay? Allah ta'ala forgive all the sins, as long as your repentance is sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, as long as you repent from that sin and you don't return back to it, okay, then Allah Ta'ala will forgive that sin from you. But if you want Allah Ta'ala to change that sin into a good deed, you have to follow your repentance with good actions. A man came and said, Ya Rasulullah, what would you say about a person who committed all sins? He didn't leave a small one, major one, or minor one. He did all sins, okay? Has he got a tawbah? Our son asked him, do you say la ilaha illallah? He said, la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. He said to him, then do the good actions, tafa'alu al-khayrat, and leave the bad action, watruk al-sayyi'at, yaj'aluha Allahu laka khayratin kulliha. Allah Ta'ala will change them, will convert them into good actions. So the bad deed will be converted to good deeds if you follow your tawbah with good actions. Okay? And then you have in the Quran, Allah Ta'ala said, إِلَّا مَن تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. Except that those people, Allah mentioned those who fall in evil actions. Okay? وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ وَلَا يَزْنُونَ وَمَن يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ يَلْقَى أَثَامًا. Those who don't kill, the soul which Allah Ta'ala has forbidden to be killed, unless by legitimate right. And they don't fall in adultery. And whoever falls in this will have a severe punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah Ta'ala, the next verse said, إِلَّا مَن تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. Except for the one who repented to Allah Ta'ala, believed in Allah Ta'ala, and followed his repentance with good actions. Okay? In this occasion, فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ. Those people, Allah Ta'ala will convert their bad deeds into good deeds. Okay? So if anyone did an evil action, then repented to Allah Ta'ala with a sincere repentance, okay, Allah Ta'ala will accept his repentance. Allah Ta'ala, the Quran said, إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا. But if this person does not pray, for example, and doesn't practice Islam, then this action that he's doing, not praying, okay, or not doing what Allah Ta'ala is commanding him, he needs to repent from that as well. Okay, so he's still in error. He's still in error. Okay, so therefore, my advice is that once we repent to Allah Ta'ala, we should open a new page to Allah Ta'ala, follow His instructions, follow His commandments, and stay away from the evil actions. And Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said,
وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى.
And take some provision for your journey of Hajj. Speaking about the Hajj. Then he said, but the best provision that you take for your life is the provision of taqwa, of piety, to be pious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be fearful of Allah, to be mindful of Allah, to be fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to have this, what you should do? Very simple thing. Taqwa, piety, being fearful of Allah ta'ala, is to stay away from that which is haram and to do what Allah ta'ala has commanded you. This is a taqwa. Ibn Abbas said, المتقون, the pious ones, are those who restrain themselves from that which is haram.
Because Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said the man who came 99 person and he goes to the abid, he asked him about the tawbah. He said, we have tawbah. But he goes to the alim, he said, here is tawbah. He tell him, yes, you have tawbah, but you have to change the place.
Good.
No. You have to change the country. If this man he do a lot of healing in his place, we would do too, but you have to change the place where we live. Any kill or drugs or alcohol or zina, you have to change the place and open new page and you do the new tuba and the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam if you want to do tawbah, you have to change the place, to change your friend, to change, and you need tawbah, inshallah.
Yeah, you have to help yourself. Help yourself. When you change the place, change the environment, that will help you to be close to Allah Ta'ala.
You know, for tawbah, yeah. They may tawbah enough to fall back into it again. I know that one of the signs of your tawbah not being accepted is if you do it again. So how does one make sure he just changes the situation completely? What practical steps can people take? Because we've already been tawbah, and then after we just do it again. Like how can we make sure that we just never return to whatever people are doing?
Let me comment on something. You said that a sign of not accepting my tawbah is that when I fall into sin again. Yeah, no, it's all right. The sign of tawbah is that you have regret inside your heart. That's enough. You have a remorse inside your heart about doing certain things that this is Allah Ta'ala, that which is not good inside Allah Ta'ala. That's enough. This is tawbah. Okay. But if you fall in the same sin again, as long as you are repentant to Allah Ta'ala every time you fall in it, then it's okay. A man came and said, Ya Rasulullah, give me an advice with which I won't be in need of any more advice. He said to him, قُلْ آمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقِيمُ. Say, I believe in Allah and then steadfast. Steadfast, what does it mean here? قُلْ آمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقِيمُ. Istiqam, what does it mean? Istiqam doesn't mean that you don't fall in a sin, because you will fall in a sin because you're a human being. Istiqamah means, steadfastness means, that whenever you fall in a sin, whenever you go out from this straight line, if you go out from it, return back to it. You go out, return back to it. So every time you fall in a sin, repent to Allah Ta'ala. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا إِذَا مَسَّهُمْ طَائِفٌ مِّنَ الشَّيْطَانِ تَذَكَّرُوا. Indeed, the righteous people, the pious ones, whenever shaitan afflicted them with anything, they will remember Allah Ta'ala, and then they will know their way. In the Quran, Ta'ala also said,
وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض.
And vie one another and compete one another in a jannah as wide as the heaven and the earth. أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ prepared for those who are pious. متقين. Who are those متقون؟ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ those who spend their money and give in charity at the time of ease and the time of difficulty. وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ and those who restrain their anger and those who forgive others. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ Allah Ta'ala indeed loves those who are good doers. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهُ And those muttaqoon, those pious ones, are those whenever they fall in a sin, they fall in any evil action, in any debauchery or any indecency, فاحشة, or they wrong themselves, ذكروا الله, they remember Allah. They will say, استغفر الله. Okay? ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم and they will seek forgiveness of themselves for their sins. ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله and who can forgive but Allah. سبحانه وتعالى. So the key for this, okay, the formula is that whenever you fall in a sin, repent to Allah Ta'ala and a sign of your repentance is that you have a remorse in your heart. That's enough. And you should have a determination not to return back to the sin again. But if you fell in the sin again, if you fall in the sin again, then again repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will end up with something. The devil said to Allah Ta'ala, in the sound hadith, Shaitan said, O Allah, by your might and your majesty, I shall continue to mislead your servants as long as they are living. وعزتك وجلالك لا أزال أضل عبادك ما دامت أرواحهم في أبدانهم. Allah Ta'ala replied saying, وعزتي وجلالي, by my might and my majesty, I shall continue to forgive them as long as they seek my forgiveness. In the Qudsi Hadith, Allah Ta'ala said, O son of Adam, as long as you call me with trust in my mercy, I shall forgive you with the greatest of ease. O son of Adam, if your sins extended reaching the horizon, and then you sought my forgiveness and my pardon, I will forgive you with the greatest of ease. O son of Adam, if you meet me with an earth full of sins as much as the earth, but you are not associating anything in my worship, I will meet you with an earth full of forgiveness. Go on, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum. Thank you. 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 Thank
Could you kind of clarify for us the difference between the kursi and the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And also because the ayah begins with Allah, could you explain to us that the difference between Ilah and Allah? Because Ilah means God, doesn't it? And Allah.
إله 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 الله.
Could you like state for us the difference between Allah and Allah in the terms of the name and clarify between the Kursi and the Arsh?
إن شاء الله تعالى. طيب. Well, Allah is only applied on Allah سبحانه وتعالى. No one has this name but Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And it is the only name, you know Sibawi. Sibawi is the one who has a book in Arabic, okay? And he defines all the words in Arabic. And when he came to Allah, he said, nothing can define Allah Ta'ala is well known. Okay? You cannot define something which is well known. Alright? Allah is Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, and there is no one that we know has named himself by Allah at all. And that's why you say Ar-Rahman. Who's Ar-Rahman? Allah. Who's Ar-Rahim? Allah. Who's Al-Ghafur? Allah. Who's the King? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People may say, we are the King, whatever. But whenever I someone say, I'm Allah. Allah, in the Arabic means, the one whom all the creation feels that they belong to him. They are part of his kingship. And every one of his creation feels that is in need of him. تأله القلوب. He is my Lord. Okay? إله means in Arabic, it means that which is worshipped. So if you have an idol, we can call this إله. Okay. People they worship the cow. This can be called ilah. Okay. But there is no ilah worthy of worship. No one has the right to be worshipped but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ilah is that which is worship. Okay? And Allah is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. Okay? Does that make sense now? Is it clear? And you say, La ilaha, there is no God worthy of worship but Allah. There is nothing that worthy of worship better we can say. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? The chair of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the size of the chair, as I said to you, is between the chair and the throne of Allah ta'ala. The chair, if you want to compare it to the throne, is like a ring thrown in the desert. It's so small compared to the chair of Allah ta'ala, the throne of Allah ta'ala. The throne of Allah ta'ala is the biggest creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the largest creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is carried by 8 angels. وَيَحْمِلُ عَرْشَ رَبِّكَ فَوْقَهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ ثَمَانِيَةً. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to us, I was given a permission to describe to you one of those who carry the throne. One of those angels who carry the throne. He said between his earlobes and his shoulder, a distance of 700 years for the bird to fly. The bird can fly from his earlobes to his shoulder 700 years journey. This is one of Allah's angels. And they are glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They seek Allah's forgiveness for the believers. They say, Allah ta'ala in the Quran said, الَّذِينَ يَحْمِلُونَ الْعَرْشَ وَمَنْ حَوْلَ. And those who carry the throne and those who are around them, the angels. الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يستغفرون لمن في يسبحون بحمد ربهم. They glorify Allah Ta'ala. ويستغفرون لمن في الأرض. And they seek forgiveness for those who are on earth. ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلم. Oh Allah Ta'ala, you have encompassed everything in your knowledge and in your mercy. فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك. Oh Allah Ta'ala, forgive those who returned back to you and those who repented to you and followed your way. They know Allah Ta'ala is the most merciful and they know Allah's power, and that's why they seek Allah's, they ask Allah Ta'ala to forgive the believers, to forgive the wrongdoers of the believers. Okay? So this is the difference between the chair of Allah Ta'ala and the throne of Allah Ta'ala. Allah Ta'ala is above the throne. Above the throne. Extends over all these things. All the heavens and the earth. And the planets and the suns, the stars, everything.
And this is just a footstool here, this is that.
Some said that, but there's no strong evidence on this. It's more the يقدم الرحمة, like there's no strong evidence of this. But the chair itself, if you want to compare it as the sound hadith to the whole universe, the whole universe is like a ring thrown in a wide open land compared to the chair of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
What's the difference in Arabic between arsh and kursi?
In Arabic, arsh is a place where the king sits on. Okay? Kursi is a chair. Chair for. Finished?
Since we've been talking about Ayat Kursi, can you give us some of the benefits of reciting it and the best of reciting it?
Jazakallah khair, good question, wallahi. The one who recites this verse before he sleeps, before he goes to bed, okay? No shaitan will come near to him until the morning. And the hadith Sahih Bukhari. Shaitan will not come to him until the morning. Allah Ta'ala will assign an angel to guard him until the morning. So if you have some bad dreams, okay? So inshallah ta'ala, read Ayatul Kursi. Not that only. The one who reads and recites Ayatul Kursi after every fard prayer, nothing will prevent him from entering Jannah but death. As soon as he died, he went to Jannah. And the hadith in Sunan al-Tirmidhi, in sound hadith. من قرأ آية الكرسي دبر كل صلاة لم يحل بينه وبين دخول جنة للموت. The one who recites آية الكرسي after each prayer, nothing will stop him from entering Jannah but death. You die, you enter Jannah. آخر سؤال, last question إن شاء الله. If you read it in the salah,
if you miss the salah,
okay,
in the time of the salah, mm, then making up the salah, mm, the,
yeah, you can still do the reading after each fard prayer, whether you pray it at home, whether you pray it in the masjid, whether you miss it, then you make it up. After the salah, you read it. Just make a habit after you finish the adhkar, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, and you read at the kursi. Get used to it, inshallah ta'ala, and you're gonna have this reward. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب جزاكم الله خير للسنين ان شاء الله ان شاء الله of course you go to the grave and this thing but you will the Rasulullah said that to us in the hadith so we believe in this we believe in it of course يعني it's gonna be in the sound hadith the time they stay in the grave okay is like a very short while that you sleep, you know when you sleep after you get married, okay? Once you sleep after you get married, and then you wake up after in the morning. Very short, isn't it? It's like this. كَأَنَوْمَةِ عَرُوسِ You sleep and you wake up, that's you are in Jannah. طيب, إن شاء الله تعالى. بارك الله فيك, جزاكم الله.